What's up guys, welcome to our channel Tej Advice. In this video we will talk about no sound on Windows 10. We will discuss about 12 points, out of which 5 to 6 are the advanced troubleshooting point. I want you to watch the complete video before you opt for any of the troubleshooting point, because sometimes we don't require that troubleshooting step and we just simply take that troubleshooting step and do that on a PC. So I want you to watch the complete video and after that opt for any of the step. So stay tuned and watch the complete video. Before going further, if you are new to this channel, then click on subscribe button and on the bell notification select all and give a thumbs up if you like the video and leave your feedback in the comment section. Point 1. Test your audio devices. As you have the speaker connected to your PC or the headphone or the USB headphone connected to your PC, what you have to do, you have to test those devices are working fine or not by connecting it to any other PC or laptop. Once you are sure that those are working fine, then you can connect it back to check if you are getting the proper response or not. Point 2. Check the device connected properly or not. If you have any headphone with a 3.5 mm jack, I want you to check those devices connected with your PC properly or not. Sometimes we do not connect the USB headphone properly with our PC and due to that we are not able to hear any voice on our headphone. Same goes for the 3.5 mm jack. We just simply plug that 3.5 mm jack to any of the socket we have on a PC or laptop and we think we can hear the sound. You have to make sure if you have the two sockets on your PC, one is for the input and the other for the output. If you want to hear any sound, then you have to connect your headphone to the output socket. Point 3. System restore. Sometimes we install software on our PC and that software causes a problem on our laptop or desktop. So it's really important for you to understand if you have installed any software recently and since then you're facing this problem, then you have to uninstall that software and check that if that helps. And if that's not working, then restore your PC onto the backdate to check if that helps you to fix the problem. For to open the system restore point window, press and hold window icon and press R, R as in Romeo, type rstrui.exe. You'll see this system restore window. Here you have two options, recommended restore and choose a different restore point. You have to click here and click next. After this, click on show more restore point to see all the restore points and restore your window as per your requirement to the recent date. As you can see here, 19/11/2020 is my recent date on which I can restore my PC if I want to go with the restore point. Point 4. Update Windows. Here you need to update your window if you have any problem on your PC. After the update, computer install the new drivers on a PC for the audio, that time a PC start working properly. For to update the Windows, click on Windows icon, click on the setting, click on update and security. And here you will get that option to update your window. Point 5. Run troubleshooting. Here you need to go for the troubleshooting step for your audio. You can do that from any of the three options. You can go with the system settings, update and security, click on troubleshooting. You will get this playing audio troubleshoot option. Or either you can just do a right click on the audio icon on the right bottom side. Do a right click and you'll get this option. Click on troubleshoot sound problems. Whatever the option you will opt for, you'll get the same window comes up. Or the third option is you can go through the system, sound and troubleshoot. You'll get the same window from any of the options. Point 6. Fix the disabled sound setting. For to fix the disabled sound setting, click on Windows icon, click on settings, click on system, click on sound. Here click on device properties and you will see this option checked so you have to uncheck this option. Point 7. Check your drivers. Here, you have to go to your device manager. For that, click on the Windows icon on the left bottom side. Do a right click and you'll see device manager. Click on the sound, video and game control. Do a double click. Here, you have to be sure which one is your driver. As I have a USB audio device connected to my PC, I'll go for this one. If you have different devices connected with your PC before, then you'll see the list here in the sound, video and game controller and the other options as well. So do a right click and click on properties. Now click on driver. Here, first you have to see this option, rollback driver. If you have this option, then you can click on rollback driver, or either you can click on update driver. If your driver is not up to date, you will see this option for sure. As I do not have the administrator right for this to do, that's why I'm not getting this. After update, if it helps you to solve the problem, then it's fine. Otherwise, you can uninstall the device. Just need to click on uninstall device, then click here and click on this scan for hardware changes. And after that, it is start scanning and you just need to reboot your PC for once. If that helps, then it's good. Otherwise, you can search for the driver provided by the company by typing the name of the headphone brand. Just need to search for the driver on internet by typing the name of the brand headphone you have. Point 8. Set a default device. To set a default device, click on Windows icon, click on setting, click on system, click on sound control panel. And here, as you can see, I have USB headphone connected to my PC. This option is selected as default. In recording, I have the same USB audio device as default, and you can see that my microphone on which I'm talking right now is responding properly, so I can set up this as my default device as well, but I do not want to go with this one. I like to stay with this one, so I'm leaving this as a default one. Once you'll select the default one, click apply and OK. Point 9. Disable sound effects. If you have set up a sound effect, any kind of enhancement on your PC, then you have to disable that. For to disable the advanced enhancement or sound effect, click on Windows icon, click on setting, click on system, click on sound, click on device property, click on additional device property, and click on enhancement, and select this option, disable all enhancement. Click on apply and OK. That's how you have to disable all sound effects. Point 10. Restart the audio services. For to start the services of audio, click on this Windows icon, search for services. As you can see here, click on open. I'm not showing you any of these. I just want to show you the audio services. Once you'll be in services, search for window audio. You'll see this thing, window audio. As you can see, it's running right now on my PC. Do a right click. You'll see this option highlighted, start, if this Windows audio is not running on your PC. So start this to run the services of window audio. Point 11. Try different audio formats. For to change the different audio format, click on Windows icon, click on setting, click on system, click on sound option, click on device properties, click on additional device properties, and you'll see this advanced option. You can select any one of these, as you can see, and test that if that helps you to fix your problem. Point 12. Check the privacy setting. Here you need to check that the privacy setting is allowed for your headphone or for your speaker. For to check the privacy setting, click on Windows icon, click on settings, click on privacy, and here you can see microphone. You have to make sure this option is on. If this option is off, that's why your microphone, your headphone not working correctly. If your device is not working on any of the application here, then you need to turn it on and restart your PC. So that's all for today to fix no sound from Windows 10. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.